Hi, this is Rick Hanson on Don't Be Alarmed, the 38th practice in my book, Just One Thing. You know, it's funny if you think about it, animals living way back when that were all confident and zen and mellow and peaceful, they got eaten. They weren't noticing the slither in the brush nearby or the crackle in the mountain, in the trees overhead. The ones that did survive, that became our great-grandparents, were nervous and spooked and vigilant and probably a little cranky as well. We're sitting on top of the food chain as their great-great-grandchildren. God help us. But anyway, so we have in us this natural endowment from Mother Nature, which helped our ancestors survive, this kind of ongoing background trickle of anxiety and sense of alarm. While it's great for keeping critters alive in the wild, it's lousy for our everyday well-being, and it's also lousy for long-term health because it keeps activating the stress system. So to deal with it, I have two suggestions here. The first suggestion is to take a stand that you're tired of being needlessly afraid. Yeah, pay attention to the real threats, but don't get sucked into what I call paper tiger paranoia. The second is to see if you can continually calm down the body, you know, the little inner iguana or inner rat or inner monkey or inner caveman, cavewoman inside all of us, speaking metaphorically here, and help them feel less alarmed so they're not needlessly anxious. So, may you not be so alarmed.